What is the investment opportunity in Cyprus?
You know, it's tricky in a way. I think there is an opportunity among the sovereign bonds. We're primarily in fixed income. And they have a June maturity coming up that's been trading anywhere between 85 and 95 cents in the dollar over the last couple of weeks. So it's trading like a stock, and it's a short maturity bond. If you think that this financial debt problem within the country, mm-hmm. or the financial system problem within the country, remains isolated there and not doesn't overflow to the sovereign, you can actually pick up 10 points in the next couple months before maturity.
Ambrose Everest Pritchard writing last night in the Telegraph. Let's look at that op-ed from AEP. Just back from Asia, what saved Iceland from mass unemployment after its bank blew up was a currency devaluation that brought industries back from the dead. Cyprus doesn't have that advantage, do they?
No, they don't. Same way that Greece didn't. And, you know, we always hear this whenever a crisis erupts, that just exit the currency, get a devaluation, you get a bounce. You know, Iceland's actually having to come back to the table to talk about doing a sovereign restructuring. So I've read a lot of articles about doing parallels between Iceland and Cyprus.
You don't agree with Paul Krugman that they should just walk out and do the Cypriot pound?
Well, that's Paul Krugman's, fallback recommendation every time. I could take a look and compare Greece to Argentina, and everybody was saying Greece should just exit the euro because Argentina was able to rebound. It's a short-term rebound with long-term consequences.
Well, Cyprus doesn't have a Cypriot pound to deal with right now. They have the euro, and of course, people are outside the banks trying to get a hold of that currency, trying to take it out of the banks. You talked about opportunities. What about opportunities in Italy or Spain?
I would be a little cautious. I think that if you take a look at the yield in a Greek bond or a Cyprus bond, you're talking about anywhere from 12 to sort of, 10 points over a couple months. You know, you're getting close to 50, 60, 70% yields. You've seen, 25 basis point backup in Italy on the back of potential elections. They can't form a coalition government. There's risk there. In fact, you're taking a look at a countries that could be on the brink of having a crisis. And you take either one of those countries, you may lose more than you could gain.
David Kotak, the issue here within Hans Hume's financial world is the real economy. The fact is Slovenia has a real economy, Spain has a real economy, and they're not happening right now. Is this perma-recession?
Well, it could be. It's long-term recession because you have a lot of damage in the financial sector. Hans is in distressed debt in euro. I had dinner in Paris with a fund manager who manages euro-denominated sovereign bonds for pension funds. He needs high grade. He can't get in the distress area. Where is he going to go within the 17 now? Germany, of course. Finland, it's a small place. How many choices does that fund manager? Even the Netherlands is now a question when it comes to economic growth. There isn't any, and problems.
And to reaffirm your research note, you're suggesting flight to quality sustains, and we see lower German yields. Do we see lower U.S. yields as well?
Well, the U.S. 10-year will follow the German 10-year down, but there's another issue, and I really got to dig into it in these series of meetings.
Right.
There's a lot of money trapped in the euro because of the repatriation tax on the United States. These are U.S. companies that cannot bring and repatriate money without a high tax penalty.
I want to get back to the banking system, though, because that's what kind of sparked this whole thing. Cyprus's banking system is many times the size of its economy. Are other countries with that same model now in jeopardy as well, Hans?
You saw the markets yesterday running at every... You know, they were going after Slovenia, they were going after Malta. The big one in play here that everybody was taking a look at that sort of precipitated what was going on yesterday was this idea that the money was coming out of Cyprus via the UK. And that, they're going to go after every tax haven economy. What I got concerned about yesterday, given the tensions between the UK and the rest of the EU, was they may start targeting the biggest tax haven of them all, which is London.
Yeah, right. Interesting. That's a break exclusive here. Hans Hume's the tax haven known as Harrods. Time for our Twitter question of the day. Where is the safest place to put your money? That's out at B-Surveillance. At B-Surveillance. I like that idea. Where is the safest place to put your money? David Kotak, you would say Philadelphia, Philly box seats?
Well, I don't know about Philly box seats. Sarasota, Florida is a preferred location these days. And Bordeaux futures.
Bordeaux futures. There it is. A Twitter question.
I just want to see David Kotak. Wind up saying gold. That's what I want to see.